So what did we learn from the Italian Grand Prix? That's what we'll look at in this video with data analysis of the race, from tyre wear to straight line speed and pace comparisons, all of which should be helpful to start predicting the pecking order for next time out in Baku. So first of all, looking at the overall average race pace of each driver, so the average lap time over the entire race, we can see Verstappen has an absolutely massive advantage over anyone else, bigger than the gap between any other drivers here. It's about 0.3 of a second every single lap that Verstappen had over Norris, which is pretty huge, especially considering how small those gaps were in quali. Norris and Piastri, if we look at them compared, Piastri was about 0.1 of a second slower every single lap on average, which did show he ended up about 6 seconds behind at that first stint. And also between Leclerc and Hamilton, that gap was even bigger, about 0.2 of a second that Hamilton was slower. And also with Mercedes, Antonelli was about 0.4 off the pace of Russell. Other than that, we had Albon pretty high up here, which he was rewarded for, and Bortoleto as well being incredibly quick. Now looking at the fastest lap leaderboard, these are the 20 quickest laps of the entire race. We can see the Red Bull domination pretty clearly, although we do have some McLaren laps aided by that soft tyre switch at the end of the race, which didn't quite work out for them, but did lead to some pretty quick lap times. Although you can see even with 15 lap old hard tyres here, Verstappen was putting in laps pretty much as quick as Norris on his soft tyres, which shows you again just how much pace they had. It's a similar story on consistency, actually. Verstappen there is once again pretty much miles ahead of everyone else. Norris also being incredibly competitive and significantly more competitive than Piastri. So this chart is the standard deviation of their lap times, which means lower is better. So Verstappen the most consistent here, Piastri the least. Hamilton actually slightly more consistent than Leclerc, and also Sainz slightly more consistent than Albon. Now looking at the laps in traffic, this can also be quite telling to give us some context into the race pace. We can see pretty clearly who was stuck in that horrible DRS train. The likes of Sainz, Lawson and Stroll for sort of 40 plus laps being stuck right behind other cars. Whereas our front runners, Hamilton, Leclerc, Piastri, Norris, Verstappen, had a lot more free air, which does add to their pace advantage. And it can also show you some differences in teammates. So Sainz had a little bit more traffic than Albon, which may explain his lesser pace compared to his teammate. So now taking a look at tyre wear, these are fuel adjusted lap times here of some of the front runners. So these lap times aim to show just the change in lap time due to the tyre wear and nothing else. Of course, traffic could affect this, and that's why I've chosen some of the front runners who weren't in too much traffic, sat behind people. And the thing that stands out firstly, if we look at the bar chart, where higher is worse, so higher is more degradation, lower is the least degradation, Verstappen did actually have the highest degradation, and this is the medium tyre where we did see actually that blistering in the first stint, while Leclerc actually had very, very good tyre wear, which we can see by this very straight dotted line. Verstappen, quite a steep line to say he did have quite a bit of wear, and that's not to say he was slow, because this line still sits below everyone else's. He still had more pace than everyone by significant margin, but you can imagine extending this line up, and Verstappen's advantage would just slowly decrease, and was slowly decreasing as the tyres got older. Similarly, on the hard tyre, Verstappen higher wear, Leclerc lower. The difference is less, though. You can see Leclerc's line slightly flatter. Hamilton not quite managing the tyres as well as Leclerc yet. And Russell sort of in a similar group to those Ferraris. Verstappen, again, slightly higher wear. But you can see just how much quicker he was very easily on this plot. And just to quickly revisit that McLaren do not have a significant tyre advantage here in Monza, and that's quite telling for next time out in Baku, which is another very low deg track, lots of straights and lots of slow speed, so we may see more up for grabs from the other teams. So now looking at some of the more general car characteristics that Monza revealed, it's no surprise that looking here at top speeds, Ferrari has a big advantage compared to everyone else, which may serve them well next time out in Baku, which also has a lot of straights. Red Bull and Kick Sauber pretty competitive, while Mercedes and McLaren struggling. Interestingly though, McLaren are of course able to make up for that with a higher mean speed, as we see here, from better downforce, whereas Mercedes didn't particularly make up that deficit that they had in top speed, which is why they were struggling. Red Bull seems like a very well balanced car. You see they've got a decent top speed, also a decent mean speed, and that's why they sit over here in this nice, relatively high efficient area. Whereas Ferrari sacrificed a lot of downforce for top speed, and McLaren didn't quite have the top speed but did have the downforce. Now, looking at who was quickest where, it's very clear Ferrari down the straights, that is expected. Interestingly, Haas in pretty much all the braking zones were the best performing car, which is an interesting one to see. McLaren good in traction zones here out of the turn one chicane, also out of the Lesmos and the final chicane there. Whereas Red Bull absolutely dominating the last parabolica, which is where we saw Verstappen pretty much take pole in that last sector. And a quick look at pit stops, we had the fastest total in-pit time by Piastri for McLaren, although Ferrari were actually the quickest in the pits overall, which was 6% quicker than everyone else on average, while Red Bull were actually the most consistent. And looking here at the time that each team lost on average to the others, ignoring Aston Martin for that Alonso retirement, we can see that Ferrari were on top, Racing Bull's very close, Red Bull Racing lost 0.2 on average, with the likes of McLaren, thanks to that very slow Norris stop, actually losing 1.3 on average. And we can see that slow Norris stop here lost about 4 seconds to Piastri, which of course caused those team order problems. So that's all for your Italian Grand Prix data analysis. It really was a bit of a shake-up of the order with this low deg, very high-speed track, really not favouring McLaren quite as much as usual. And I think that very much could be the case next time out in Baku. So it will be all to play for the likes of Red Bull, Ferrari and even Mercedes if they can get their act together. If you want to see more analysis like this, then I'll be covering all of the sessions at the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. So do drop a sub if you're interested in that. But thank you very much for watching.